Hello and welcome back to Mr. C's Biology. Today we are talking about the brain, and you might be thinking by the title, hang on, surely I've got blood in my brain. How's it going to get things like oxygen? How's it going to remove waste products? And you are correct, there are lots of blood vessels around the brain, but there aren't any inside the brain tissue, and I'll explain why in just a moment. But for now, we're going to get on. We're going to look at the structure of the brain, what are the different main parts of it, and what do they do, and we'll go from there. Let's crack on. Okay, so your brain is divided into lobes, and so in the diagram, you'll see there are different coloured sections, and each of these sections has a different function. So we've got the frontal lobe, that is all to do with processing, memory, lots of things like thinking, that all comes from your frontal lobe. As we move further back, we've got the parietal lobe, that's got a lot of sensory information, so it processes your sensations, things that you touch, things that you feel, your taste, that goes into your parietal lobe. On your temporal lobe, it's all about auditory, hearing, understanding speech comes into there, whereas actually saying things and language goes into your frontal cortex. So speaking and listening and understanding, that conversation actually takes a lot of energy in order to do it properly. Now your occipital lobe at the back, that is all to do with visual processing, and so sight and seeing things goes into your occipital lobe. And then as you move further down, things get a bit more primitive. So your cerebellum sits beneath your occipital lobe, and that is also to do with fine motor coordination. So now we're down to movement and things like that. And so that motor coordination is things like writing, where you've got to move different muscles in your hand to write something neatly, or it might be something like playing a musical instrument where you've got to really think about where your muscles go. That fine motor coordination is from your cerebellum. Cerebellum means little brain, cerebrum meaning brain, and then if you've got a little LO on the end, then it means it's a little one. And it looks a little bit like a little brain when you look at it. As we go further down from the cerebellum, even more primitive is the brain stem. So probably just the top of your neck. That is where things like coughing and controlling your heart rate, things that aren't really voluntary, things like changing your breathing rate, that's all controlled by your brain stem. Things like digestion happen in that part as well. So hopefully that's given you an overview of the brain. One extra feature that means that your brain does not have blood in it is the blood-brain barrier, the physical barrier between the blood and the brain. Now, why is it there? Actually, blood gets pretty close to the brain, but it doesn't get there. And so in your brain, you have cerebral spinal fluid. And this is the fluid that goes, coats your brain and coats your spinal cord as well. And so that is really important in getting the nutrients to the brain so it can get the oxygen it needs and take away things like the carbon dioxide and other waste products as well. But we don't want potentially harmful bacteria getting into the brain. That's the bottom line. And actually, if we've got a barrier and we can separate those, we can keep toxins, harmful bacteria, things like that in the blood where they can go off to the liver, be dealt with, processed, excreted through the kidneys or through a different system. Whereas if they got into the brain, that would be really dangerous and actually could cause a lot of damage very quickly. Some of the issues of this though is that when we want a drug to actually influence the brain, so something like a drug designed to treat a mental health issue or a psychiatric issue, we want the drug to get into the brain, but we need to then design it so it can cross the blood-brain barrier, and that's a lot harder than it might sound. One new technique that I've read about that is starting to come onto the market is using some ultrasound to temporarily open up the blood-brain barrier a bit, but I think it's still a work in progress rather than a common option at your doctor's. So hopefully that's helpful. Hopefully you now know why there's no blood in the brain, and you know a little bit about the brain as well. Do comment below if you've got any questions. I'm really happy to answer them, really enjoy seeing your questions, and I'll do my best to keep the conversation going in the comments. If you like this video and you like the idea, there are another one coming up on hormones. We've got some study skills stuff coming up too. Then do click subscribe and join in. There'll be a live stream coming up as well. I'll publish the date for that very soon, and we're gonna have a live question answer. If you've got some questions in advance of that, so I've got something to talk about and you might not make it, there's a link in the description to a questions form that you can fill in, submit your question, and then I know that I've got a few to start me off, and then if you join me there, then I'll answer the questions live as well. As ever, thanks for supporting this channel, thanks for being here, and I'll see you next time.